This is the basic tutorial on camera animation for the beginners. I'll just play the scene. We are going to simply set a camera for this basic animation. It is a very simple scene, a very basic animation towards the box, and we will create a camera that will follow the box. So first we need to create a camera. You need to go to create camera and then camera. Then you can simply place your camera and you can see where it's pointing. So this is all be visible from the camera perspective. You go to panel, perspective, camera one. Now you can see from the camera. Few things you need to keep on. Yes, now you can see your resolution gate. This is all what you will be visible in camera. So our point of interest and our object is this cube. So next what we need to take care about, focal length. It is a long scene. The lower we focal length we have, more perspective it will give. For this kind of scene we need a higher focal length. So let's have a higher focal length, 75. Looking that better, we'll go with that. So this is going to be our first frame. We're going to lock the first frame. Our scene is not idle for this, so I'll just extend the model. Okay, we are applying the rule of third here. This is the best we can get. Okay, so this is our first frame. I'll just key our at the first frame. So you can select your camera from here, or you can select your camera from outline by clicking on it. Once your camera is selected, you can see camera one here and this white line. Make sure to turn on your resolution gate. This is here. Once your resolution gate is on, you can see this white line. So whatever is visible inside this white line is will be visible in your animation and your render and play blast. So I have selected my camera. This is my first frame. I'll just key press S after selecting the camera. Now you can see the red dot here. Let's not worry about where it goes. We know the last frame. So how are we going to end the last frame? We want the last frame. Let's extend the BG as well. Okay, so we want the last frame like this. Why do we want this? So just to keep it a little interesting, we need to show space where the object is moving. Now the object is moving right to left. In the beginning it was moving left to right. So where it's moving towards right, we show more space towards right. And when it's moving towards left, we will show more space towards left. So these are the basic fundamental in camera setting. So we just set camera for two frames. If I select the ball, I'll jump to perspective. You can press a space bar and right click on the center of Maya. The perspective view comes up. I switch to perspective. This is my camera. If I select, I'll see two key. I'll press S on both point. We need to make sure Y rotation needs to be zero. I'll just zero it. Reset the camera. Y and G supposed to stay zero unless you needed it. So I'll check the camera again. This needs a little pan. My auto key is on, so it will automatically take the key. The trick to work with camera is to keep less keys. More keys you will add, you will have more trouble. So definitely we're going to need a third key here. If you study the ball animation and the motion, it goes right for the 50 frame and goes down for 18 frames and comes back till 120. So our camera need to be here at 50. So I'll just pan the camera at 50 and I just roughly set it. I don't know what's going to be visible. So let's go to the camera again here. So now the ball is going to move towards bottom. So this supposed to be, let's keep it, it's not moving now. So let's keep the ball at the center right now. I don't know how it's going to come. I'm just blocking right now camera roughly. Now the camera supposed to be here. I'm again keeping the ball at the center. No, I won't keep the ball at the center. Why? Because my last frame, this is the height of my camera. Okay, if it goes up and down, it will abrupt. If I see from here, this is y-axis. So here and here, the y-axis supposed to stay same. The less changes in the camera, more stable it will be. So I keep the y value from 68. It's not 68, the last y value. I'll take the y value from here, command C, and I paste it at 68. So there will be no movement further in y axis. See, it's stable. And here also there is a little y movement, but it's not noticeable because it's transitioning. So I think this is pretty much okay. The ball is not in the center by why? Because the ball is moved at 57 towards x. So we will move the camera a little bit in the x axis. So we are trying to keep the ball as much as possible in the center while it's going down. And when it's going right, we are keeping space in the right, and when it's going left, we are keeping space in the left. So this is our animation pretty much done. There is no background in there, so we can't register the camera. I'll just quickly add some elements in the background so we can notice the camera animation is there. I simply add some element to notice the speed and jerk in the camera. So it is pretty much okay. There is a little jerk in this camera. You can notice the sudden move in the y axis is creating a little abrupt animation here. So let's fix this up. Now as I said, the more key we'll have, the more abrupt it will look. So let's go to the camera. Let's first select the camera and we go to the graph editor, Windows animation editor, graph editor. So the x-axis we will see every axis one by one. So this is our y-axis. We can see the drop here. And why, what is this key? So we don't need this key. I'll delete it. The lesser the key it will have, more smooth it will become. We need something like this, but we can't do it. So we can definitely see there is a jump in this settling. We'll go back. It's pretty better now. Let's see the other axis. The X is pretty much smooth. If I just delete these keys, it will be more smooth. Let's check now. Yeah. X is pretty much smooth. The Y has a little jerk. Let's check the Z axis. Why do we have an animation in Z axis? So what is Z axis here now? We can see this is our Z axis and we don't actually need animation in Z axis. So as much as we avoid the other animation, it will be smoother. So we don't need animation in Z. We'll delete the keys on Z. So the camera will stay at his point. Next is X rotation. There we don't need any rotation animation. There is no rotation animation. So this is good. So all we only have animation in Y and X. X is pretty much smooth. The Y is not smooth. So let's figure out to smooth this curve. So let's see the animation first. Okay, so from this point we are feeling the jerk. Whenever we are modifying the tangent, we need to make sure there should not be any overlapping. So as you can see, there is a little overlapping. I have selected the tangent. As I modified, it disturbed a lot. I need to stay focused here. Okay, so I'll keep it low. This should not be going out. Now let's see. I don't know, it will affect the animation a lot. So what's happening now, our camera started to go down already before the ball goes down. And we can do the same at the end. There is another trick we can do. First, let's check the graph option. Again, we need to be sure this should not overshoot. I'll keep it low. Okay, let's minimize. Yeah, you can see if you check the bottom line how smoothly it's going down. So this is a nice Y animation. So there is a now jerk in the cube animation, you can say. Now our camera is smooth. There is another trick we can do. I'll just undo what I have done. So this was our previous graph where we had the jerk. I will try adding some extra key and try to do it manually. So let's add a key at 40. We don't need key in X. As you see, as a key added, the graph disturbs. And just 110 frame after the last. We don't need here. We'll try to smooth the curve by adding keys. This is to make sure it won't overshoot, but I doubt. So let's try, see if it's going to work or not. You can see again still there is a jump. Let's see the animation now. So it's little better, but still there are certain jump, but both tricks can be used. So you can use the both tricks to create your camera animation. That's it for today, guys. Thank you for joining, and do some good camera animation. Make sure to lock your camera. Bye bye.